Hello students, welcome to the fun known. Today we are going to see sets. So we'll understand what are different contents of the sets. We have seen intersection, but we will now see in Venn diagram. Intersection we have seen. Now how we have to see this intersection in Venn diagram? Let us consider the similar example A, B, C, D, E, F. Set L, A, E, I, O, U, set V. So intersection between L and V is A and E. This we know. So how we are going to do in Venn diagram? You can consider this. See, this is the first circle, or you can consider as oval, which include B, C, D, F, A, E. That is L. This whole part, this whole elements are there in L. V contains A, E, I, O, U, S. But you can see both the members have some different members. Both the sets have some different members. But both the sets have some common member A and E. So it can be denoted as like this. When two ovals merge with each other and the common members are written like this, that means this A and E can be shared by both the sets. That is A, E. So this is how you can show intersection by overlapping of sets. Now students, the region in the middle of set L intersection V is just showing the intersection between these two sets. Example number two. There is one more example, students. Here there are three sets A, B, C. Set number A includes H, J, K, O, V. Set number B includes H, K, O, P, T. Set number C includes G, K, P, Q, T, V. So if I am doing intersection of both A and B, so what are the common things? H is common, O is common, K is common. So A intersection B, H, O, K. If I am doing intersection between set A and set C, what are commons? I think V is common and K is common. Yes. If I am doing intersection between B and C, what are common? P is common, T is common and K is common. So yeah, we have written. So A intersection B, A intersection C, A B intersection C. You can see, students, this is how the Venn diagram will be of this following question. You have to write different sets. Set number A, which include H, K, O, V, J. Set number B include H, O, K, P, T. And set number C, which include V, K, P, T, G, Q. But here, as you can see, we have to do it interaction also. We have to show the intersection of all the sets. So you can see over here, when you talk about set intersection of A and B, you can see which are the sets H, O and K. If there is an intersection between A and C, you can see V and K. If there is an intersection between B and C, you can see P, T, K. So this is how you have to show in Venn diagram, that this is how the intersection will be of A, B and C. Set AB, set AC and set BC. The middle region, this is whatever the middle region is. So middle region, you can find out the middle region is K. Means K is common in all the subsets or sets. You can see A also contain K, B also contain K, C also contain K. That's why you can write middle region, that is A intersection B intersection C. That is the answer is K, because K is common in all the three sets. This is how you can draw a Venn diagram of intersection, which can be shown by overlapping each other. So each sets and each subsets are overlapping each other, and you can find out the intersection between them. And lastly, we have also find the common intersection, that is K, because K was common all over. Next, students, we'll understand something which is known as union. The union of two or more set is the set containing all the members of both sets. So union is written as U and often, so denoted by the symbol of cup. So each member of union should be listed only once. So you can see over here, A is 2, 5, 7, 8, B is 1, 4, 5, 7, 9. So what is union between them? We have seen intersection. Intersection means finding out the common term. What is union? Union means it can be written, the union of these three set or two set, it can be written together. As you can see, students, so A union B, if I'm telling 2, 5, 7, 8 union 1, 4, 5, 7, 9, this together will be a union set. So all the values of A plus all the values of B together will be known as union. As you can see over here, A will include 2, 8, 5, 7, B will include 5, 7, 1, 4, 9. So together it is known as union set. The union of three sets, whatever the three sets, if it will be, the union of three sets can be written as A union B union C. But you have to remember, students, union itself means all the members. So if someone is asking you A union B, so you will mention over there 2, 5, 7, 8, 1, 4, you will not repeat the value, okay? So 5 and 7 you will skip, and 9. So you have to remember that you will not repeat the value in union, but you will write union of the set means all the members. Now, there is Venn diagram to show HCF and LCM. What is HCF? HCF itself is known as higher common factorization. Okay, so an LCM is lower common, whatever factorization you can say is. So let us understand with a solution. Express, there is a term 24 and 90 as a product of prime factors. So you can see, if you are going to factorize this both values, 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 and 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. These are the factorization of these two numbers. And here we will draw the Venn diagram. 24 is written 2, 2, 2 into 3. And 90 will be written as 2, 3, 3, 5. When you are just taking these two sets and you are just putting that into Venn diagram, you can see 2, 2 into 2, 3 will be the common value, and 3, 3. So this is how you can actually see over here that 2, 3 will be a common intersection between both, that is 24 and 90. Okay. So HFC, if you are finding out highest common factor, so 2, 3 is a common factor. That's why 2 into 3, 6 will be a common factor. And if you have to find out least common factor, that is LCM, you can multiply all the values, that is 2, 2, 2 into 3 and 3, 5. All the values you can multiply. So it will be 360. Okay. Yes. Next, students will understand disjoints. What are disjoint set? Disjoint set are set which have nothing in common. That means they don't have anything common. They do not share any members. The intersection of disjoint set is always an empty set. Means there is one set which is AB and one set it is D and C. Means AB is 100% different, D and C is 100% different. So when you are finding intersection between them, you will find nothing. That's why the intersection will be empty. As you can see in example, A contained 1, 2, 3, 4, B contained 8, 9. So both the sets are disjoint, because when we find intersection between them, there is no intersection. They are 100% known as disjoint sets because they does not have any common members. Next is, there is a set which is S which contains 1, 2, 3, 4. There is a set which is T which contains A, B. So these sets are also disjoint, because when you go and find out common between these two sets have no intersection between them. The intersection is empty set, and that's why they are known as disjoint set. That is, here the common members doesn't exist. Next, we are going to see about universal set. What is universal set? Universal set is a set containing everything you are dealing with. Means all together. Universe. And you know the word universe itself says all together. Everything together. So, universal set is a set containing everything what you deal with. It is usually denoted as you. All other sets or subsets includes in universal sets. So, in Venn diagram, universal set is usually drawn a rectangle. For example, see, this is one set or this is one set considered as A. This is one set considered as B. There are some E and F also outside. But all together, there is a rectangle. So, this contains A, B, C, D, and E and F. That set is known as universal set, which include all the values A, B, C, D, E, F. So whatever the value inside that set or some other set which is present inside that rectangular box will be considered as universal set. Next is not complement of set. The complement of a set contain all the member of the universal set which are not a set. Complement itself or not itself says opposite. Whatever if you are saying these are the intersection and if you are saying not, that means opposite to that, whatever the answer is. Let us see with an example. The complement of A set can be written as A and a small dash over here, that is a small hyphen you can consider, that will be considered as a complement. So universal set, there is J and K. J is 2, 4, 6, 8 and K will be 6, 3, 9. All together you can see over here 1, 5, 7. So this is all the universal set. So here if you have to find out complement of J, that means what are members of J? 2, 4, 6, 8 are the members of J. Here they are telling complement, means we don't have to write the members of J. So you have to skip all this member. You have to skip 2, 4, 6, 8. So leaving 2, 4, 6, 8, whatever the members are, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, this will be the members. So complement itself means whatever the members are, you have to skip that and you have to take the opposite or the other members of that. That will be considered as a complement. I think that's it for the day, students. We'll see you in the next class. Thank you for being with us on the Fun Known.